Hi, I'm Rob, and this is my lovely dog Pepper. We love exploring the many footpaths here in the beautiful county of Devon. Sometimes we do a bit of photography, but mostly just relaxing scenes set to music. So sit back, relax, and enjoy Walking Devon. Well, it's a beautiful day today. I'm out here on Woodbury Common and I picked up this book by Hugh Stoker. It's called East Devon Walks. Now, I got it from eBay, but I don't know if it's still in print, but you can still pick up second-hand copies just fine. This is in great condition, cost me about £3. Contains several walks around East Devon. It contains 19 walks, and I'm starting off the first one, which is Woodbury Castle and Hawkland Breaks. Now, I'm just approaching this in a slightly different point where this chap starts. He did these in the 1980s, and he was known for also writing books on angling, quite a prolific author. Lived in Dorset, not far from here really. He starts off at the Woodbury Castle car park, and I've actually caught a bus here to where Woodbury Common meets Aylesbury Common. I'm going to follow the route that he describes in this book. My route's going to be a little bit longer. What I'm going to do is put links to the Ordnance Survey plotted routes that I'll create, and I'll share them with the description below. I'll do two routes. I'll do the route that I'm actually taking and the route that he takes. So whether you do this route by bus or by car, you can choose the route that will work for you. It's about, I think it's going to be about 7 miles for me, and if you did it by car, it'll be about 5 or 6, I think. I've been out here before, Woodbury Common, but obviously I want to follow these walks, and maybe let's see if it's possible to do all these walks without the need of a car, and you can just do it by bus instead. Now, I've just come, I'm back on the common. I've just gone through Hawkland Breaks. Now, the route Hugh Stoker suggested was to just follow this path that I'm on now. But I just jumped into the forest. There's a little gap just as you approach it to Hawkland Breaks. And I recommend actually diverting off the route and going through that forest, because it's a nice little forest there. And it gives you a different scene to walk through, because this is all moorland otherwise. I should have brought my wellies. There's lots of puddles around today, but it's okay. There are roots around them, so it's not like I'm getting wet feet. But if you're coming out this time of year, or when it's been raining, I'd recommend bring wellies rather than walking boots.
Woodbury Castle is an Iron Age hill fort. The fort is situated on a high point of Woodbury Common at approximately 185 metres or 600 feet above sea level. It is set in a commanding position with views up and down the Exe estuary and across Lyme Bay in both directions. The earth ramparts are over 6 metres or 20 feet high, separated by a ditch. During the Napoleonic Wars, this was an important strategic position, and British troops were encamped here from 1798 to 1803.
Can you hear that? The army are out here training. I just bumped into one up there, nice lad. Just had a nice chat with him. He had a little dog with him. Limpson Royal Marines. They're out here training. Fun, fun, fun.
I'm changing the way that I provide prints of my photographs. I'm going to close my website. What I'm going to do is provide a link below to the images that I take during these videos, and you can download them for free. But I'll also provide a link where you can make a donation. You can either print them at home or get your preferred professional printer to print them. Now, obviously, this isn't for commercial use, this is for your own use. I will also go through all my previous videos and provide that for each video so far. So if you have a picture in mind, bear with me, it's going to take me a little time to go through them all, but you'll be able to do it that way. I think this way, at least you can pay for what you can afford. If you haven't got much money, you know, don't worry about it too much, but if you can afford to pay, that'd be great, because all the money I'll put into reinvest into equipment. Now, I've still got quite a bit of the walk to go. The sun is getting low. We'll see how it goes. There's lots of paths around here. You could spend days up here walking around. It's lovely. But let's crack on. So I meant to mention earlier, because I've deleted my website, I've had to delete the last four videos because it mentions my website. So for posterity, I'm going to re-upload those videos with them edited so they don't advertise my website. I'll upload them after this one over the coming week, and I'll try and set it so people don't get notifications. But if you want to watch them again, feel free to watch them again. They will be uploaded in 4K this time, so that they will be better quality. Well, I've completed Hugh Stoker's circular route, and very nice walk it was indeed. You've got woodland you walk through, across the common, which is moorland. There's the Iron Age fort there. And you know, you can see the sea from here as well. Now all this around here is what I call pebbled heathlands. I've mentioned this before when I've been up in Muttersmoor about the pebbled heathlands. I'm going to walk down to Newton Poppleford to catch the bus, and you know, that's an interesting name, Newton Poppleford. Now basically popple is an old English word for pebble, so Newtown by the pebbled ford. That's where it gets its name from. I thought that was interesting. So I've taken a few photos. If there are any, I'll pop them at the end as usual. And I'll put a link down below where you can download them. Okay, well, anyway, that's it for today. I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's the usual like and subscribe. You know, the like button really does help these videos. So if you could do that for me, that'd be fantastic. But until next time, take care.